Hey guys, right, today, well tonight, because it's nearly midnight, I thought I'd give these a try. They're like cream contour colours and colour correcting. And this one, which is a green colour corrector from W7. Because, look, I don't want to pretend that I know everything about makeup. I know fuck all about makeup, to be honest with you. And it's just something I like to learn about. So that's why I've been watching a lot of Pixie Woo. I've been asking lots of questions, different YouTube counters about how I do things. So I thought I'd give it a go. You know, I thought, no point being afraid of it. Sorry if I'm a bit out of focus as well, I've just changed the light. Because I've noticed it was going to be yellow, so you know. Right, so first, I've looked at myself in the mirror for once. I know they've got a lot of, to me it looks black, like really dark around there, like I've been punched in the eye. So I understand that if you put a yellow, if you put a pinky salmon-y shade, this one, around it, it should counteract it, so on my finger. I'm just gonna put this around. Okay, right. Now I'm gonna use my beauty blender to sort this out, because I'm always afraid in case I pull too hard on the skin around my eyes. So, you know. Okay. I think you can hear my sister. I'm just going to put a bit more around that because it kind of looks a bit dark still. Okay. So it does look a bit more brighter than that, to be honest with you. Obviously it's still sunken in because you can't really use makeup to get rid of the sunken inness, whatever. Now I've got a bit of redness around my nose. As you can see, I've got burst capillaries on the side of my nose, and I've got a bit of redness around my face and the spot right there. It's hormonal, don't worry about it. Okay, right, now I'm going to use the yellow shade to try and cancel out the redness around my nose and a bit on my cheeks. I know that you can still hear my sister. She is quite loud, to be honest with you, but you know. Kind of goes up there a bit. Now obviously I've not done the other side of my face, I'll be doing that after. Right, and I'm back. Okay, so I'm going to continue with this yellow stuff to try and cancel out the red, because I've got a pretty red undertone to the face. Now I'm just going to blend this in again with the beauty blender. Right. To be honest with you, I don't know if this is going to be like part of the everyday makeup I do, because I'm not really bothered about everything showing through. But if I want to go out somewhere nice and I don't want the redness showing. So you can already tell, that side's a bit more red, but that's more nicer, and I like it. And to be honest with you, this is the first time I've actually tried this out. I've tried the contours out, I've not tried the colour correcting. And it's not greasy on my face, I quite like it. Right, but I have tried the green out, and I hated it. So I'm going to use a W7 green concealer to cover up the spots that I have. Okay, and I just realised I've got more capillaries in my eyebrow area, the side of the burst, which is quite annoying. See, I don't really notice this type of stuff on my face, but right, now that bit is done. I've got that one there. I'm going to go in with my Boing concealer and try and make it all look skin toned. Just pop it in like that. One side looking a bit more better, that side looking like, yeah, I've not had sleep in a couple of months. Right. I think it does look a bit better, but I know that I've still got, you can still see a vein going around like that. Which I kind of like, actually. I don't mind that so much. Right, I'm going to come back and I'm going to do the other side of it. Right, I'm back. I just had a slight malfunction with the camera. It was on time lapse, not videoing, and that's a mistake. So, I've contoured. I put the cream contour on my face. I used a mix of these three shades here because I didn't want it to look too orange, and I think these shades are quite orangey up here. So I used a mix of those. I went down here. On my nose, across my forehead, on my chin, and I'm currently going back in with a bronzer to try and add a bit of texture now. I have put a sheer foundation on. And cameras. I hate cameras. I hate iPads. I can't use them. Right, I'm going to go back in this side. Okay, let me see what I was doing. Right, back under the chin. Tell you what, I'm really technologically inept. I think. Well, I know. Okay, I'm back in with the bronzer down here. And yeah, it's. I'm not going to lose my temper with this bloody camera anymore. I'm not going to lose my temper at all. Then I turn off the camera and it goes against the wall. Guys, I don't know. It's like, I can't function at this time of night, to be honest with you. I don't function, I just float about through time and space. Right, completely different subject now. Has anyone watched Doctor Who? Because I've missed this series and I kind of want to watch it. Just don't tell me any spoilers, okay? I kind of want my nose to look a bit more straight because I have had a broken nose, so you know. Right, I'm going to use my pad brush and I'm going to add a bit of highlight. So it's going to be a bit here. I do like the finish of this, you know, but I'm probably going to look back at this tomorrow and like be like, you should not do makeup. A bit down the centre of the nose. here. And I'll do a bit under my eyebrow as well. I'll use my finger to do under the eyebrow because the brush is a bit too chubby for me to handle under there. Might add a bit of blush. I'm just getting a bit carried away here. I'm just going to do my entire makeup. So, yeah. I kind of look a bit plastic. That's probably what is putting me off, but. Oh. And there we go. That is my finished attempt at using colour correcting and contours. Sorry about having half the bloody video chopped out. Now, I quite enjoy it, but I don't think I have the patience to do this every day just to. But I am. Because I've already started doing this now, I might as well just finish off my entire makeup. Sorry. I think that some of this stuff, I may have to try and find a different palette because that's kind of making my face itch. But I do like it. I like the shine. It actually looks like it's a purpose to be shiny, but I still hate being shiny. Anyway, I hope you all enjoyed this video. If I've done this right, let me know, because I am quite proud of myself. I look human, but I know I'm not human. So I'm kind of a bit out of it, because as I've told you, it's nearly midnight and I'm tired. Right, speak to you all later. Have a good day, night night, and bye bye.